Shalom. Before I get started, I want to say, Kol Halayim La Yahawa Bahashem, Yahushai, Bahashem, Bahakodash, which means all praises to the Heavenly Father, Yahweh, in the name of His only begotten Son, Yahushai, which is our Lord and Savior, and to the Holy Spirit. Divine is to the apostles and elders of great wisdom who teach and will, and peace and love to the elect of the nation of Israel, and come back again. Through the spirit power of Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Recha Kodash, on the Buddha Ana from the GMS Memphis camp. The name of this lesson will be titled, Don't Let These Leaders Cause You to Sin. So, Lord willing, this lesson be edifying to the elect. Get right into it, let the scriptures do the talking. This is Proverbs 29:5. A man that flatter his neighbor spread a net for his feet. And I want to go into the word net. Before I go to the word net, let's go into the word flatter. This in the Hebrew, chalak. And we get straight to the point. The second definition, to be smooth, slippery, deceitful. And that's exactly what you see with these leaders. They are very deceitful, very smooth with their words. They are their father, the devil. You see? So let's go into the word net. In the Hebrew, washat, it said what? Of leaders leading people to sin. So don't let these leaders cause you to sin, cause you to err. You see what they're saying? Especially now with this agent, chief evil, right? Calling all camps. What did the Lord say though? The Lord said don't follow a multitude to do evil. If it be possible, you know, live peacefully. Peacefully with all men. But he said, call all camps. Round two, pull up. No, don't do that. Don't let these leaders cause you to sin. Are they teaching you another name? That's another one. Because the Lord said, have no other gods before me. Saying, Most High Christ bless. I Grave, Carmel, Barbarito, whatever, Burrito, I don't know, man. Those not the right name. Cause you to go off. Don't let these leaders cause you to sin to go off, man. You see? Because Lord said, what? You walk contrary unto me. Let me see some. Leviticus 26. Boy, I got this highlighted. This, come on, man. Let's, Leviticus 26 and 24. Let's start 23. And if you will not be reformed by me by these things, but will walk contrary unto me, then will I also walk contrary unto you. You don't want that. You don't want the Lord to walk contrary unto you. Come on, man. So you want to do the right thing. Do what's right in the sight of the Lord, man. So then will I also walk contrary unto you, and will punish you yet 7 times for your sins. You know? Then it say, what, Romans 12 and 17. Is it Romans 12? It's like Romans 16. Hey, but I quoted this. Let's read it. Recompense no man evil for evil. Provide things honest in the sight of all men. If it be possible, as much as light in you, live peaceably with all men. Don't follow a multitude to do evil, man. But these guys want you to walk contrary to the laws. That's commandments of Yahweh Shemashah. The commandments of Yahweh Shah. They don't want you to follow in the footsteps of Yahweh Shah. He's the best example, the prophet example, man. You see? He told us what to do and how to please the Heavenly Father. It's like I'm losing my voice. But this is Romans 16 and 17. Now I beseech you, brethren, mark them which cause division and offenses contrary to the doctrine which you have learned, and avoid them. Right, stay away from them. You see? It said, for they that are such some not our Lord Yahweh Shah Mashah. Right, they're not serving the his only begotten son, Yahweh Shah. They're not serving Yahweh Shah. But they own belly, right, but they own personal interests. And by good words and fair speeches, right, flattering words, right,
And by good words and fill speeches, deceive the heart of the simple, right? By smooth talk and glowing words, they deceive innocent people. What this Eli told his son, 1 Samuel 2 and 24. Nay, my sons, for it is no good report that I hear. You makes the Lord people to transgress, to go off. You see? Because what is it saying? Transgressing of the law. And what is the penalty of it? Death. Don't let these people cause you to die, man. Listen, hey, walk in the spirit so you won't fulfill the lust thereof. Walk in Yahweh Shah, hear the ways, truth, and the life. Look it up for yourself. And that's why the scripture says in Proverbs 1 and 10. My son, if sinners entice thee, consent thou not. My child, if sinners entice you, turn your back on them, avoid them. That was in the NLT, Proverbs 1 to 10. You see? I'll jump to 15. It say, my son, walk not down the way with them. Refrain that foot from their path. My child, don't go along with them. Stay far away from their paths. Stay far away from these guys, man. Follow not multitude to do evil. You see? What it said, be continually with a godly man. I get that. I know it's a survive. Yeah, I think I know what it was. Let me see some. Yo, Sirach 37:12. But be continually with a godly man whom that knowest to keep the commandments of the Lord, whose mind is according to thy mind, and with sorrow with thee, thou shalt miscarry, right? So don't follow these wicked guys, these wicked leaders, man. These guys pretty much causing you to go off, man. Don't let these leaders cause you to sin, to err. What it said, in day they are led of them. No, let's get that Isaiah 3. The, you know, just the last part of it, but let's read the whole thing. I put Proverbs. Isaiah 3 and 12. It's for my people, children are their oppression, and women rule over them. Oh, my people. They which lead thee cause thee to err, right? They which lead thee cause thee to err and destroy the way of that path, right? NLT. Just this part. This line upon line, right? Let's read the whole thing. Cause Esau, Edom, you know, women, you know, it said childish leaders oppress my people and women rule over them, right? And this is a new thing in the earth that a woman should go past a man. These guys are childish, man. That nigga is childish as hell. This like some high school shit, round two. Anything can happen out there, man. You can get shot, you know. Eat somebody, drop a bomb or pallet. Come on, a nigga will bling. Round two, pull up. That's some high school shit. After a football game, nigga want to meet up in Burger King and throw blows, man. These leaders are childish. You know? It's a, oh, my people, your leaders mislead you. They send you down the wrong road, and that's what we're telling you. The Lord said, I said, not these prophets, but if they had stood in my counsel, Jeremiah 23 and 22. It said, let's read 21. I have not sent these prophets, yet they ran. I have not spoken to them, yet they prophesied. But if they had stood in my counsel and caused my people to hear my words, then I should have turned them from the evil way and from the evil of their doings. But what they telling you? To go and commit evil, run down to mischief, falling out a multitude to do evil. Especially in the time we coming into the hour of temptation. Right? These leaders are gonna cause you to err. We seeing the same thing. 2020 was the prelude. These leaders, these celebrities. What that nigga say? Vats that thing up? I'm not giving out medical advice. It's safe and effective. So when Esau say this mandatory microchip, mark of the beast, I'm not giving out medical advice. It's okay to take it. The RFID chip is not, the mark of the beast ain't the RFID chip. This is what they say. It's okay to take. You can repent for it. Come on, man. Don't let these leaders cause you to go off. It said, let no man deceive you by any means, right? They're telling you, come on, man. That's what I say, the leaders, Isaiah 9 and 16. Get ready to end it. for the leaders of this people caused them to err. Right, for these leaders sending you down the wrong path, man. They are hirelings, don't care about the flock, the sheep. It's saying they have led them down to slaughter you. Isaiah 9:16, King James. For the leaders of this people caused them to err, and they that are led of them are destroyed. Right, you're going to be destroyed if you follow them, man. Matthew 15:14. Let them alone, right? Ignore them, right? Right, say that. Ignore them, man. Let them alone. They be blind leaders of the blind. And if the blind lead the blind, both should fall into the ditch, right? Exactly what's going to happen. Lord going to destroy both of y'all, man. It said, let every man be fully persuaded in his own mind. So it's on you. We gave you that one. You see? And it was the right. No. Praise to y'all. This is my shot. This is the right 4:22. Accept no man against thy soul, and let not the reverence of any man cause thee to fall. Right. The reverence of any man, man. You see? So don't let these leaders cause you to sin to go off, man. These leaders are wicked. You know, that's sending you down the wrong path, man. And these are pretty much grievous wolves, man. I know I said I'm going to end it there, man, but I want to get that one, man. I know Acts 20, the 20th chapter. Let me see some. Yeah, Acts 20 and 28. Start 27. For I have not shunned to declare unto you all the counsel of the Most High. Take heed therefore unto yourselves. Into all the flock over the which the Holy Spirit had made you overseers, to feed the church of the Most High, which he had purchased with his own blood. For I know this, that after my departing shall grievous wolves enter in among you, not sparing the flock. And that's exactly what you see. False leaders, false teachers, pork chop pastors, celebrities. You see? But they're gonna be destroyed, man. In due time. It's another one that came to mind. It's lucky, but I wish it didn't come back to me, man. But I believe the point being made. If it comes back, I put it in the description box. So once again, I want to give our praises to Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shai Bashem, Kodash, the bonus to the apostles and elders of great men stone who teach and will well, peace and love to the elect.